Hello, my name is Bethel Jonathan. I want to welcome you to BNJ Forest FS Academy. This class is mainly for those who want to start forest, you know, trading. Beginners, it's mainly for beginners. And I will be taking this class from the beginning to the end. And please, if you find this video interesting, don't hesitate to hit the subscription button. So should in case if we drop another video, you'll be among the first set of persons that will see this video. And we want to start by asking ourselves, what is forest? Without wasting much of our time, we'll go to straight to the point. And the question is, what is forest all about? The question is, what is forest? And before we go into that, we said that forest trading is profitable if you are serious and you follow the lecture bit by bit. Now let's go direct to the introduction. What is forest? Forest stands for foreign exchange, which is exchanging one currency for another. You sell one currency and buy another currency simultaneously. And once you do so, you have essentially involved yourself in forex marketing. Some persons do say that they don't want to do forex, they don't want to trade forex and all that. You don't want to trade forex, but you know, always want to exchange the dollar you have to Naira, or in case of Nigerian, another currency. You want to exchange the dollar or the other currency you have to your local currency in order you to make use of such currency. So once you've done that, you've indirectly or directly engage yourself in forex trading. You've indirectly engage yourself in forex trading. So for example, let's say USD versus NGN. When you travel to US, you have to exchange slash sell the Nigerian currency you have to buy USD in order you to make transaction in the United States of America. So what we are trying to say in essence is this: there is no how you go to United States of America with Naira and be purchasing something. The citizen over there will not accept. But in order it to be easier for you, for easier transaction, what you need to do at that juncture is to exchange the Naira you have to that of dollar in order you to buy something or transact, do any transaction easily. So at that juncture, it will be easier for you to, you know, make transaction. And we said the market is open 24 hours every day, 5 days a week, and has different sessions depending on what time it is. So the market is open, forex market is open 24 hours every day, 5 days a week. For those of us who is trading volatility, The market is open every blessed day for those of you that is trading volatility, step index and all that. The market is open every day. For those of us who is trading pair currency, it's 24 hours every day for 5 good days. That is from Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday. And the market will close for those of us who are trading pair currency. Yeah, we say currency are always quotes in pairs, such as USD, ZAR. Where you buy one currency and sell another currency. So what we are trying to say in this year is that currencies, for those of us that is trading pair currency, currency are pairs. You don't trade one currency, you can't trade the only USD. You must pair the currency, neither USD versus euro or USD versus BTC, USD versus Australia dollar and all that. So there must be a pair using one currency to buy another, you know, currency. So at this juncture, it's important for us to know forex terminology. There are some basic thing you need to know in forex language. I call them forex language. Here we have basic currency. And we say the basic currency is the basic for the buy or the sell. Example, if you buy USD versus NCR, this simply means that you are buying the base currency and selling the quote currency. Why the quote currency is the second currency? The quote currency is the second currency in any currency pair. The first, the base currency is the first currency, while the quote currency is the second currency. You should be able to know that. What I'm trying to say in essence is that once you see a currency pair in this form, this is base currency, while this is quote currency. The next thing we have is long slash bullish. Remember, we are trying to know the terminologies of forex. Anytime you come across long or bullish, here we said in trader stock, going long slash bullish means buy. So anytime you come across when somebody said long, the person is indirectly telling you you should buy. Or when somebody said bullish, the person is indirectly telling you you should buy. Here is short slash bearish. So when somebody say bearish, the person is telling you to sell. Or when somebody say short, the person is indirectly telling you you should also sell. We have pip. Pip means percentage in points. A pip is the smallest price movement available in a currency. Example of it is this. The fourth decimal number, example. The fourth decimal number, immediately after the dot, the fourth one, you count 1, 2, 3, the fourth one. This the pips. If USD slash ZAR move from 13.3979 to 13.3980, it's equals to 1 pips. So many persons have been asking how do they calculate pips. So this is how they calculate it. For instance, where you have USD slash Japan, 100 points, 100 points, 509. Use third decimal number, ask your peeps. So should in case you are using USD slash JPY. So you use the third decimal as your pips. Let's see lot size. Have lot size. Value used to determine profits or losses. So lot size are value used to determine profits or losses. We have standard lot size, we have mini lot size, we also have micro lot size. So standard lot size is 1.0, which is equals to $10 per pips. So once we are using 1.0, a move of it will give you 10 pips. So it means that if you are in profit, it will give you $10 profit. If you are in loss, it will also give you $10 loss. We have a GMT, meaning Greenwich Mediterranean time. Remember, we are trying to see the terminology, forest terminology, that you'll be coming across as we proceed in this class. The next we have here is what is traded at the forest market. These are what we trade in forest market. Forest can be traded with the following: gold, silver, oil, crypto, AUD, is Australian dollar, CAD, AUD, CHAV, AUD, JPY, ATC, even gold, silver, and so many can be traded in the forest. In forest, we do two basic things basically in forest. It's either we are buying or we are selling. You know that two things we do in forest, neither buying or selling. If you follow this class step by step, you won't mix it. So let's see who trade the forest market. These are the people, the person, personality that trade the forest market: banks, companies, retailers, government. They buy and sell pears in the forest market. So except for the retailers, I call the other trade the big boys. Yeah, they call the big boys because they have influence and capacity to move the market to any direction at all they want. Here we said they are called the big boys because they have the capacity / equity to move the market. The retailers are individuals like you and I. All we do is to follow the big boys. So they have the big boys, being the banks, the companies, the governments. They have the equity, the money to redirect the market anywhere. Our own as retailers is just to follow the market anywhere, you know, the big boys, you know, push the market. And this, what we have here is a location of forest market. Forest markets are not located in any physical location, like your local market. It is decentralized online. Is decentralized online because there is no physical, you know, location of forest market. That is why you need a broker. So forest market is not located in any place. It's not located in your market, your local market, where you go and buy goods and services, not at all. So it's basically online. That is the reason why we need a broker to rely on. Forex brokers. On your own, you can't access the forex market. That is the role of forex brokers. That is the role forex brokers play for you. So there is no how you access forex market without forex brokers. Forex brokers are organization or firms that gives you a trade access into the forex market. They provide a trade. They provide a trader with a trading account. They give traders leverage. They provide technical support to traders. Here are various brokers in the forex market. The brokers include Derif, Hot Forex, FSTM, FSCM, LBS, Binary. As still Binary is still the same as Derif. When you have Derif account, still the same thing with Binary account. So at this juncture, we'll stop here to our next class, where we'll be treating on the trading session. Our class will stop here today. Please, if you find this video interesting, don't hesitate to hit the subscription button. So should in case our next video is uploaded, you'll be among the persons, that will partake on the next video. If you find this video interesting, please do well to hit the subscription button. Thank you very much. And secondly, if there is any question, don't hesitate to ask your question. Thank you.